name's Jamie. I'm going to go over the different types of oxygen masks and different types of administering oxygen. So first and foremost, when administering oxygen, you would always check for a doctor's order. You would always verify your patient by two patient identifiers, being maybe the patient speaking and a bracelet, and then you would kind of go from there. You would also determine the state of your patient, whether they are in severe respiratory distress or just a minor respiratory issue. You would also determine what type of oxygen to put, determining the situation of the patient. So we will first and foremost start off with a nasal cannula. So this is what a nasal cannula looks like. You put it on the patient like this. You make sure that this is down so you don't choke the patient, and you make sure that these tubes are facing at an upward angle, not upside down. So you want to just put the tubes in the patient's nose and place these behind the ears, but it is very hard to do on a mannequin because he doesn't really have ears, so it would look just like that. When setting a nasal cannula to the oxygen, you would set this at a rate of 1 to 6, 1 being the lowest, 6 being the highest, at an oxygen percentage of 24 to 44. When using a nasal cannula, you also may use a bubble humidifier. Bubble humidifiers are used for anything from 4 to 6 liters on a nasal cannula. What a bubble, there just happens to be one connected here. So what it looks like is I would plug this in right over here, and I would set the patient on 4 liters. This would then humidify the oxygen that is going to the patient. You always make sure you plug into the green outlet being oxygen, yellow being air. And then you would administer the oxygen with a nasal cannula. Nasal cannulas are used for patients that need a very low amount of oxygen. Also, they're used for COPD patients. You never want to administer too much oxygen to a COPD patient because you could cause oxygen toxicity and you could cause a wipeout of their respiratory drive. You also want to be aware, if they are CO2 retainers, that their oxygen may be low and that may be their normal. So for a CO2 retainer, a normal oxygen may be 90%, whereas my normal oxygen for a normal healthy adult would be 98 or 99%. So we just need to be aware of that when providing oxygen. Secondly, we could go up to a simple mask. This is what a simple mask looks like. We can set a simple mask liter flow to the oxygen from anywhere from 6 liters to 10 liters. This type of oxygen mask supplies 60% of oxygen to 80%, I believe it's 80%. You place the mask on like this. You put the mask snug to the patient's face, and you make sure you play with this metal bar, adjusting it to the patient's nose, so it's a nice, good fit. And then you plug in this oxygen to an oxygen tree, which I'm going to take this humidifier out. You plug it into an oxygen tree. And like I said, you can start at 6 liters, and you can go up to 10. So I'm on 8 or 8, about 9 right now. So a big important thing about the simple mask is you never want to go below 6 liters. Going below 6 liters can cause the patient to then inhale CO2, which could cause them to go into a respiratory acidosis. So you want to always make sure that you never go below 6 liters on a simple mask for a patient. So next I'm going to show a venti mask. So the venti mask is I'll pretend I have a cord. A venti mask, all of these look different and come different depending on what hospital or nursing home that you're working at. And you also always want to look at the doctor's orders when looking at this, because they all have a different liter flow and different oxygen percentage that will come out of the liter flow. So they will say it on these little connectors that come. Never go by the color. The colors are always different. So for example, this connector is 10. I'm going to connect this right to the bottom. And then I'm gonna connect my oxygen tubing from here to the oxygen flow meter. This piece right here says 50% and 10 liters, which means that I'm going to give my patient 50% of oxygen using 10 liters. So this is a very corrected type of way to administer oxygen. Next, I'm going to show a face tent. So a face tent, all this is rather than a patient going on a mask, it's just a different type of mask which goes right underneath the chin like this, and it sends oxygen into the patient's nose and mouth. I'm also going to show a non-rebreather. So this is the one piece of oxygen where you do not need a doctor's order. Non-rebreathers are used in emergent situations. If you can see that a patient is desatting and not coming up with a regular nasal cannula or another simple mask or venti mask, you get your non-rebreather. And these are not meant to stay on patients for a long period of time. These are very short acting, whereas we can get the patient either stabilized on a BiPAP machine or intubated, whatever they need to do. Non-rebreather is always set at 10 to 15 liters, and you place a non-rebreather over the patient's face the same way that you place a simple mask on. You make sure it's snug, and an oxygen cord will come right out of here and connect to this flow leader where you then would set at 10 to 15 liters. You also, when inflating a non-rebreather, when you plug it into the flow meter, you want to block off your top piece right here and have this bag blow up. You never want to put this on a patient with the bag deflated. That'll mean that the patient will not be getting enough oxygen that they need through this mask. So you want to hold down, make sure the bag is inflated, and then place on the patient. Lastly, we have a nebulizer treatment. So these nebulizer treatments can either come in a mask form or a pipe form, a mouthpiece form. This one happens to be in a mask form. What this is a mask connected to a nebulizer, and you can set it. You can place up to 10 cc's of medication in here, and you set this between 8 and 10 on the flow meter. And again, you place it on the patient at a snug fit, and you can connect from 8 to 10 liters. This will create an aerosol mist for the patient, and this is medication only use. This is not used as an oxygen device. You can plug this one into either air or oxygen to use. And that's it. Thanks.